Okay, well, hello everyone. In this session, we will be simulating the input and output characteristics of common base configuration using NPN BJT, and then later on, we will see also using PNP BJT. So let us begin our simulation. First of all, we will be building up this schematic in LTSpice. So let us start. So this is our LTSpice window. So here we have already selected a new schematic. Now let's start building up the circuit. So we'll go to components and select NPN transistor. So this is my NPN transistor. I can rotate it as per the requirement. Okay. So here I have to make the arrangement that the emitter terminal has to be on that side. So here it is. I have used this feature of mirroring image. Here it is, my transistor is ready. Now I have to add the resistors. So here is one resistor. I'll control R to rotate. I'll place it over here. Another one, I'll place it over here. Next, we require two voltage sources. Okay. So for two voltage sources, again, we'll go to components and select voltage. So here I'll place one over here. And here it is, one is reverse. Like this, right? Yeah. So now we have added up all the components. Now we'll join them together quickly with a wire. So here it is. The connections for the output side. And then this is for the input side. And the base terminal is there. So this is a common base configuration. So your base terminal will be common between the input and the output side. Here the input side is the emitter and the output side is the collector. So here we'll connect with the ground or wire. So now all the components are connected. Only thing is the labeling part is left out. So we'll complete the labeling part now. So this we have to right click and go to advance and click on none and select OK. We'll remove this V term. So that is there to, you know, to make it variable. So again, right click, go to advanced, click on none. Now we can vary the value of these voltage sources. Let us rename it as VEE. This value, this will be RE. The value will be around 1 kilo ohm. Then this resistor value, it's also 1 kilo ohm. The value of RE resistor, this is RC collector resistor. It's also 1 kilo ohm. And this supply is VCC. So we can right click on V1 and call it as VCC. It's very important to do this small step. Okay. And also we can rename this NPN transistor by NPN1 and this Q1 by Q1 underscore your name. That is to get the unique output. Input and output curves in your name. Okay. So right now I have to add the dot model statement. So I'll right click, go to draft, go to spice director and add over here dot model NPN1 NPN BF beta is equal to 100. So this I will add it in the statement. This is required because we want the NPN transistor to have a beta value of around 100. That is very, very necessary. Fine. So next we will label the terminals emitter, collector and base. So I'll right click on the wire, click on add label and I'll add E. Similarly here and here. So here I will add as B. B stands for base and this is collector. Capital C stands for collector. Okay. So I am ready. I'm done with the circuit now. So next is, let me go to the simulate button. Here is the procedures and all are given. So I will go to simulate, click on run, and then click on DC sweep. In DC sweep, they will ask for the first source. So the name of the first source will be VEE. See that you have given the same name over here. If you have given V1, you write here V1. But for simplicity, we are taking it as VEE. Start value should be 0, stop value should be 2, in the increment will be 0.1. Similarly, name the second source as VCC. VCC. Also type linear. Start value, we can give it around 5. And stop value will be 20. And you can give the increment as 5. Okay. And click on OK. As soon as you click on OK, a blank screen will appear with the X axis as 0 to 2 volt. And a dot DC statement will also appear. So what does this dot DC statement indicate? It indicates that your VEE voltage source is varying between 0 to 2 in the steps of 0.1, and VCC voltage source is varying between 5 to 20 volts in the steps of 5 volt. Okay, that's the meaning of the statement. Now, next we have to plot the graph. So for plotting the graph, the input characteristics of your common base configuration is a plot of emitter current versus base to emitter voltage, IE versus VBE. So what we will do is, when we click on simulate, a blank screen will appear. Right click on the blank screen and click on add trace. There you see select IE, emitter current. Now remember, we have to enter a minus sign before this IE, because LTSpice it considers emitter current in the opposite direction. That's why we have to write a minus sign whenever we are measuring current, i.e. whenever we are plotting the current emitter current in a BJT. So we have to prefix the minus sign over there and click on OK. Fine. So when you click on OK, this is the graph which you get. But this graph is of VBB versus IE. This graph is of VBB versus IE. But what do we want? We want a graph of IE versus VBE. So for VBE, what do we do is, let me just explain this in short. So basically, VBE is equal to VB minus VE. And we know that over here, VB is zero. This terminal is connected to zero. So what we can write, VBE is equal to minus of VE. Okay. I hope that this point will be clear. Base emitter voltage is VB minus VE. Base terminal is grounded. So VBE will be equal to minus of VE. So in order to do that, your x-axis has to be VBE, right? So in order to do that, right click on it and change it to minus of VE. Okay, so this is the graph which you will get. Okay, one more thing I wish to add over here is, you can right click on the transistor and pick a new transistor. From here, we can select BC547B also. That is also okay. And when you click on okay and run, you will get a family of curves. As you can see very clearly, if I expand this, see there are at least 4 curves, which will correspond to different values of, let me show you in the screen, different values of VCC. Okay, for each unique value of VCC, we have plotted these curves, as you can see over here. Okay, so this circuit diagram, your schematic, you can take the print screen, and the output waveform also, you can take the print screen. So this was just a demonstration of showing you the using the BC547 transistor also, but I'll rename it back to NPN1. Okay, so now what we have to do is, now there is a table. I mean, we got this graph, right? IE versus VBE. This is the graph we have. See? Say almost similar. Your x-axis is VBE and your y-axis is emitter current. So this is the graph which we get. Now, we have a table which we have to take care of for this experiment. Okay, so for this, what we have to do is, here we were taking VCC simultaneously and we were varying the value of VE and VCC simultaneously, but here we have to remove the secondary source. So right click and remove the secondary source, and now we have to manually give the value of VCC. So for the first case, we have to vary the value of VEE supply voltage from 0 to 2 volts, and we have to keep the value of VCC fixed at 0 volt. So I'll right click over here and I'll add over here 0 volt. Okay, so your VCC is fixed now. So you won't get a family of curves, you will only get one curve. Okay, so for this, we have to measure the value of VBE and measure the value of IE. Remember, in LTSpice, ammeter current is measured in the opposite direction. That is why we have to add a minus sign towards in LTSpice for your ammeter current. Okay, so here if I simulate this, I will get a graph. This is the graph which I get. Okay, now from this graph, I have to determine VBE and IE for these values of VEE. Okay, it is a possible job, but it is a very tedious and a time consuming job, right? To measure all these values for these particular value of VEE, we have to measure the value of VBE and IE. Nevertheless, this graph is of ammeter current versus the base ammeter voltage. Okay, so we will be using dot measure statement to find those values. So let me show it to you how to use the dot measure statement. So basically what we are doing is, for VCC equal to 0 volt, we are finding the values of VBE and IE for these values of VEE voltages. Fine. And with the help of dot measure statement, we can easily do that. So we can write dot measure DC. Let's first find the value of IE. So we will write IE1. Find how does the IE look like in the diagram. In the same manner, we have to write minus IE of, bracket Q1_your_name. So same manner, we have to write it. Find minus IE bracket Q1_name. This will be finding that when VEE supply voltage is equal to 100 millivolt. Okay. So basically we are asking the LTSpice dot measure statement, find the value of ammeter current when external supply VEE is around 100 millivolt. Now we will copy the statement and add the more and more points. Okay. Yeah. So this will be, this is just the label IE1, IE2 and IE3. This is just the label. The increment points will be 100, 200 and then 300. Let me copy these three statements now and I'll similarly add more. So this will be IE4, IE5 and IE6. Then the VEE value will be 500. Next it will be 600. Then 800. Okay. Two more values I have to add. So for completion of readings, here we have to take it as IE7 and here it will be IE8. When VEE is equal to 1 volt and 2 volt. Okay, so what the statement will do? The statement will calculate the value of ammeter current for these values of ammeter, the supply voltage VEE. Okay, so let us copy this statement from here and add it in the LTSpice schematic. Okay. So let me go to the schematic. Here I'll right click, go to draft, go to spice directive, and I'll add these statements. Let me make the font size as 1 also. So I've added the statements over here. Now, this was about finding the value of emitter current. What about finding the value of base to emitter voltage? So for that, what we have to do is we have to again write the dot measure statement DC and then the variable name will be, let's say, VBE1. So we have to find VBE. Now, what is VBE in the schematic? VBE is nothing but minus of VE, right? So we write exactly that. Find minus of VE when VEE is equal to 100 millivolt. What is the meaning of this line? This line meaning is you find the value of base emitter voltage when VEE supply voltage is 100 millivolt. Okay. And in this way, we have to carry on writing this statement and it will store the value in VBE1. Okay. This will store the value in VBE2 when VEE is equal to 200 millivolt. And then cumulatively, we have to build this up. So this will be VBE3. This will be 300 millivolts, 500 millivolts. This will be VBE4. Okay, I'll add the four statements. I'll take the next range. This will be 5, 6, VBE 7, VBE 8. And ranges will be up to 500, we have 600. I am referring to the left hand side table. So 800. Then we have 1 volt. And last reading will be 2 volt. Okay. So what this statement will do? This statement will automatically calculate the value of VBE in this table and give it to you when we execute the LTSpice. So again, I'll go back to the schematic, right click over here, click on draft, click on spice director and add these statements and give the font size as 1 so that it fits the screen. Yeah. So with the help of these statements, now I can calculate all those values. So again, I'll simulate, I'll click on run. And now we are getting this graph, right? Now we have to fill up this table, correct? VCC equal to 0. This is plotted for VCC equal to 0 volt. So we'll click over here. And now, in order to view those values of IE and VBE, we have to go to view and click on spice error log. Okay. So you click on spice error log. These are the values which we are getting. So these values you can copy. See, remember, what are you doing is you are taking the print screen of the schematic as well as the output waveform, and you are storing those values inside your Word document. Okay. So please take the print screen of your schematic as well as the output waveform as soon as you get it. And for the plot, for the space error log, these values, as you can see, these are the values which we are getting. These values you can manually copy it from here and enter it in your Word document, which you can paste it in this table. Okay, so these are the values of 8 values of emitter current and base emitter voltage, these values of VEE supply voltage. Okay, so that's how you can write this. So what's the meaning of this 0.1, 0.2? 0.1, 0.2 means VEE supply. Okay, so this is the value of current IE1. It is storing in this variable IE1, IE2 to IE8. So for these particular unique values of VE, different values of VE, we have 8 values of emitter current and 8 different values for base emitter voltage. So in this way, please take the print screen of entire schematic, or else you can also attach the print screen of this, but then you have to manually enter these values. So suggestion is, in your Word document, just copy this, the spice error log values. Okay. And now what we have to do is, now it's very simple. Now we have to just make VCC as 5 volt. So I'll go over here, make this as 5 volt in the print screen and simulate it. Here is the output with the changed values. Okay. So you can take this print screen and here you can view the values directly. Automatically it will come. See? So this table, IE values and VBE values also for VCC equal to 5 volt, you can fill it very easily. Similarly, for VCC equal to 10 volt also, we have to do the similar thing. So here VCC is equal to 10 volt. And now if I want to run again and view it, so you can check the spice error log over here. Okay. So we are getting the graph as well as the spice error log values, which will contain this emitter current and base to emitter values, this particular value of VEE and for VCC equal to 10 volt. Okay, for every case you take the print screen and keep it safe in a Word document, offline Word document. Okay, so this was about the input characteristics of common base configuration using NPN BJT transistor. Now let's move on to the output characteristics. So let me select. Okay. So this is NPN BJT. Using NPN BJT, the output we have to simulate the output characteristics for the common base configuration. So there is no change in the diagram at all. There is absolutely no change in the diagram. Only thing is we will remove this value of 10 volt from here. And we will remove this dot DC statement because it will be slightly different in dark case. and we'll delete the output plot. So circuit is ready. We have to modify it a little. Okay. So this is the same circuit for the output characteristics. See, in case of your common base configuration, the output characteristics is a plot of IC, collector current, versus collector to base voltage, VCB. Okay. So for doing that, we have to follow certain rules. So first of all, whenever we make this circuit similar to what we have done before and go to simulate, click on run. This is in continuation with the input characteristics. Now we are focusing on the output characteristics. For the output characteristics, select DC sweep. And now the first source to be, you know, first source to sweep will be VCC. Type of sweep will be linear. I am referring to the left-hand side document. And this is zero. Stop value is 10. Increment is 0.1. And then for the second source, we have VEE. Okay. And name it properly. These voltage sources should be named properly. Start value should be zero. End value is 2. And increment is 0.5. And then click on OK. The moment you click on OK, your blank screen will appear with the x-axis from 0 to 10. This is basically your VCC. Fine. Let me maximize this and show it to you. This dot DC statement will appear onto your screen. VCC, it means that VCC supply voltage is varying from 0 to 10 in the steps of 0.1, and VEE supply voltage is varying from 0 to 2 in the steps of 0.5 increment. Okay, so that's what the meaning of the statement means. So now we are ready to simulate the plot. So for simulation, it's a plot of IC, right? Collector current. So we'll go to simulate, click on run, and right click over here, click on add trace, and select collector current. Okay, so we are getting this plot. Is this the correct plot? No, this is not the correct plot because x-axis is my VCC. Okay. I want VCB. So let me go to the schematic and tell you, help you out, what is VCB. So this is VCB. VCB will be VC minus VB. VB voltage is zero. So your VCB will be equal to your VC voltage only. I hope this is clear. Your VCB is VC minus VB. Base voltage, base terminal is connected to ground. So VB voltage will be zero. So VCB is nothing but V of C. So in this plot, go to the x-axis, right click on the x-axis. Now delete this VCC and instead write V of C. Okay. And we are using this label terminal. This is the collector terminal, right? Which we are labeled it. So V of C means it is x-axis is VCB. We have seen that before. So as you can see, this is how the plot will look like. Okay. This is what the plot will look like for family of curves. So you can take the print screen of the schematic as well as the output waveform. Fine. So yeah, it is, as you can see, it is crossing zero and going to the negative side also, as it is shown in the left-hand side graph. Now we have to again fill up a table. Okay. So we have to, right now what we did was in the output characteristics, we have varied the value of VE also. Supply voltage VEE, we have varied the value. But right now we want for one particular value of supply voltage. So we'll remove VE from here and I'll add it externally from here. So here I can write it as 0 volt. So the 0 volt has appeared onto the schematic. That means my supply voltage VEE, instead of varying, is now right now 0 volt, constant value, right? At this instant of time, I wish to check the output. Okay, so this is what the output looks like. Now I also want to measure the value of IC and VCB for these different values of VCC. Okay, so again I'll use the I will have to use the dot measure statement. So right now what are we measuring? We are measuring the value of IC as well as we are measuring the value of VCB. So over here we have to do some changes. Instead of IE, These dot measure statements was for input characteristics. And for the output characteristics, what will be the change? Wherever you see IE, replace it by IC, collector current. Okay. So here I am replacing them by collector current. Here you don't require a minus sign. basically the collect current is measured correctly in LTSpice. Only it is the case of emitter current which it delivers in the opposite direction. So I have to find the collector current. Now instead of VEE, I have to write over here VCC. So these are the changes which we have to do. Okay. Now the ranges are also different. So we have over here 0 volt also. So we will start with 0. And then it is 100, 300, 500. Then we have 1 volt. Then we have 3 volt, 5 volt. Let us skip the 8 volt. Let us go to 10 volt. Okay. So these are the ranges. You can also add 8. Doesn't matter. It will not make a difference. So these statements will directly measure the collect current for these values of VCC. Now next, we are going to find VCB. Okay. Next, we have to find the value of VCB. So to find the value of VCB, we have to first of all have to change this label to VCB, the variable names, VCB everywhere. Wherever it is written VBE, we have to replace it by VCB. So these dot measure statements will help us to calculate the DC voltage and current values very, very easily. And here the minus sign will not come. It will be V of C only directly. As we have seen in the schematic, your collector to base voltage will be just equal to the collector voltage, because base voltage is connected to the ground. Base terminal is connected to the ground. So yeah, and this will be when VCC equal to, so everywhere you replace it by VEE by VCC. We have to enter the ranges also. So it starts with 0 when VCC is equal to 0, then 1, 300, 500, then we have 1 volt. After that, we have 3 volt. After that, we have 5. And we are skipping the 8 volts. We are directly writing the 10 volt. You all write everything. Okay, just to save time, I'm doing that. So now let's copy the statements, dot measure statements over here onto the schematic. So earlier ones, we can delete it. It's not required. And now we will add the new ones. Earlier ones were for the input characteristics. Now we are entering the output characteristics. So we can directly enter over here. Font size, we can give it 1 and attach it. So this is to find the collector currents. And next will be to find the collector to base voltage. So I'll right click over here, click on the draft, click on the SPICE directive, add all the statements. Font size, we can keep it at 1, around 1. Okay. So now we are ready. Now if we simulate this, we have to take the print screen of the schematic. This is the output and these are the values of the, so what we need to do to check those values, go to view, click on the SPICE error log. So you see, these are the values which we are getting. So for these are the values of collector current and your VCB value. This is V of E. No, it should be V of C. Yeah, let me change this. It should be V of C. Yeah, I will let you know what happened. So we have to make it as V of C because we are measuring VCB. So everywhere we have to make sure that it is V of C. Okay. And now if I copy the statements again over here, let me replace the earlier statements with this. Okay. Now it is perfect. So now if I simulate this and I'll get the graph, I can check the SPICE error log for all these values. So these are my values of collector current and VCB values for corresponding values of VCC and VEE. VEE is 10 volt now. Now in the next case, we can make VEE supply voltage as 1 volt. And just we have to simulate. All the values will come automatically. So this is what my graph will look like. And for the readings, we have to go to spice error log. So these are the values, all the values of collector current and collector to base voltage for VEE equal to 1 volt. Okay, for these corresponding values of VCC. So as you can see, this 0.1, 0.3, 0.5 is nothing but my VCC value. So for that VCC value, what's the value of collector current? And for that VCC value, what's the value of VCB voltage? So this is my VCB voltages. Fine. In this way, you can proceed. And lastly, we can check it for VE equal to 2 volt. So just we have to make this change, one change. Rest all the readings are automated. So we'll click on run. Yeah. So this is what we'll get. Okay. So you have to take the print screen for every case and to note down the values of the spice error log, which will show you all the, so these values which we have to enter in this table. Okay, so your job has become very easy. All the values are automatically available now. Fine. So in this way, you complete the output characteristics for common base configuration in case of your using NP and BJT. Okay, so what we will do is now we have completed the analysis for the input and output, for finding the input and out, plotting the input and output characteristics for common base configuration using NP and BJT. Okay, and now we will do within next five minutes, we will complete it for PNP BJT. So let me open that OneNote document over here. So we have to do it for PNP using PNP BJT common emitter input characteristics. So right now our circuit is output characteristics. So let's first do output characteristics. Okay. So this is the schematic given to us. So over here, the polarities of the supplies are different, as well as instead of NPN, we have PNP. So only this much difference is there. So what we can do is we can delete this transistor from here, and from the library, we can add a NPN transistor quickly. So we'll go to library and PNP transistor. We'll rotate it. And we have to mirror image it also. Yeah. Now we can add it. PNP transistor onto the schematic has been added. And now we have to right click over here, make it as PNP1. Okay. And obviously make the Q1 underscore your name so that you get a unique characteristics and your name is already written in it. And rest all is same, only the polarity of VEE and VCC are reversed. So what we will do is we'll click on this, select the supply and we'll rotate it. Similarly, we'll click on this VEE, rotate it, let me select this and then rotate and add on the screen. Yeah. So this way, as you can see, now the circuit is similar to what is shown in this left hand side OneNote PDF, OneNote document. So yeah, so this becomes now my common base configuration output characteristics for common base configuration, we are measuring the output characteristics. We are checking the output characteristics. And very quickly, we have done the circuit analysis. So let me just delete it and click on OK. And now, instead of dot model NPN and NPN, we will write PNP. PNP. And here also, we'll write PNP. And click on OK. Fine. And very small changes are there. Now, in order to check, yeah, let me show it to you. So let me show the first characteristics. Let me delete this graph. So here, let me delete the dot model, dot DC statement. So once you are ready with your circuit and added the dot model statement, what you do is for the output characteristics of common base configuration using PNP transistor, you go to simulate, click on run, and then click on DC sweep. There the first source to vary will be VCC. So almost same procedure is there. Everything is same. This is 0 to 10 and in the steps of 0.1. And the secondary source to sweep will be VEE. So we have done the same thing in when we have done with the PNP transistor. Exactly same. So right now, if I want to plot the characteristics, so it's a graph of IC versus VCB. Okay. So I'll right click, add trace, I'll plot IC. So this is the graph. This is the graph which we get. But this graph is of IC versus VCC. So what we have to make, we have to change it to VC, V of C, because we know that VCB is nothing but VC minus VB. VB is zero, so VCB will be VC. So I'll right click on the x-axis and I'll change to V of C. So now this is the graph which we'll get. Okay, so you see over here, this is the graph which we get for the output characteristics of common base configuration using PNP transistor. Okay, now for the particular cases for the table, we have the same table, no change at all. So, you know, going from NPN to PNP is very simple. Just reverse the supply and just replace NPN transistor with PNP transistor. That's it. Rest, all the things are absolutely same. Let me show it to you. So in this, I have to remove the VEE part now, because VEE I have to give it separately from outside. So let's make VEE as 0 volt first. So I made VEE supply voltage as 0. And now I'm simulating the characteristics. So this is the graph I got. Okay. And remember, we have written the dot measure statement for NPN transistor. Exactly same statements will remain over here. Nothing will change. Absolutely same it will remain. Okay. So what we need to do, just go to simulate, click on run, and here it is. This is the characteristics we get. We'll click on view, go to spice error log, and these are the values. See, as it is, very simple. So when you did the entire hard work in your while simulating the NPN, you know, using NPN transistor for common base configuration, you know, moving it to PNP, it's very, very simple. So as you can see, the current and the voltage values are coming out to be negative for using NPN transistor. So these are the values. So these values, we have to fill it in this table. Okay, these values will come negative, obviously. And then we'll change the VE supply voltage to -1 volt. 1 volt over here. It's already connected in negative. And now if we simulate it again, it will very well come in the third quadrant. And this is the correct plot. We can go to view and go to spice error log, and here it is. So these values we have to enter in this table. These are the collector current values and collector to base voltage values for VE equal to 1 volt. Similarly, for VEE equal to 2 volt, we have to do the same. So again, go to simulate, run. See, this is the characteristics which we get in the third quadrant. Fine. So you take the print screens properly, go to spice error log, and note down all these values and fill up this table. These are the values of collector to base voltage, collector current for VEE equal to 2 volt, and for these values of VCC. Okay, here I have not added for VCC equal to 8 volt. You have to add that statement over here. So that's it. This completes the output characteristics. Correct? Now input characteristics, similarly, you can do. Let me open that document of input characteristics so that we don't do it again. PNP common base input characteristics. We have already seen this for, this is how we do it for input characteristics. So what changes I did from the, let me show you to you the NPN input characteristics. Let me close this first. Okay. You remember we have done this much for the input characteristics for the common base configuration. Now let's go to the input characteristics of common base configuration using PNP transistor. So for the PNP transistor, this will be the changes. Your supply voltage VEE will be reverse. The supply voltage VCC will be reverse. And instead of NPN, we are using PNP. So when you do this modification, rest all is same. Also the dot model statement, in the dot model statement, we have to write PNP1, PNP, BF equal to 100. BF means beta equal to 100. So only those changes, after those changes, if you do those changes, you will get this graph. I mean, you will get this schematic. Okay. So I leave it up to you to make this much. And also the dot measure statement will remain as it is, as it was for using NPN transistor. Now let's quickly simulate this and complete our work. So for the first source to vary over here, let me delete this. So this is the first source to vary. So let me right click. VE 0 to 2 in the steps of 0.1, exactly the same. Second source is VCC. Start value is 5, then 20 and 5. That's it. And then you click on simulate. And for this, it's a plot of IE versus VBE. Okay. Now remember, when we add the plot of whenever we plot collect emitter current, we have to add a minus sign here. But this plot is of emitter current versus VBB. We have to plot VBE. So for plotting VBE, exactly the same thing we have to do. Let me add over here one line. So VBE is equal to VB minus VE. That is equal to minus of VE. Because your base voltage is connected, base terminal is connected to ground. So your VBE voltage is nothing but your minus of VE voltage only. So in this graph, on the x-axis, you click on it, right-click on it, and change this to V of E. So this is the correct graph. Okay. Now, in order to get the family of curves, we have to right click on the transistor, pick a new transistor, and you can select it as BC557B. You can select, this is a PNP transistor. So once you simulate this, so you will get the required plot as it is shown over here. Okay, a family of curves. If I expand it, you can view it. Fine. So this is the way we can check the general family of curves graph for the input characteristics of common base configuration using PNP transistor. Now I will bring it back to the normal PNP one. And I have to, take the measurements as per this table. Okay. So very quickly, I have to delete this value of VCC. Fine. And right now I have to give the value of VCC as 0 volt. So I'll right click, give it to 0 volt. And now if I simulate the plot, so this x-axis I have to change to minus of V of E, and I have to plot the value of emitter current. So this is my emitter current. Remember to add the minus sign. So this is the graph. This is my graph for VCC equal to 0. And now if I want to measure the, note down the value of emitter current and VBE voltages, I can just click on spice error log. Okay, automatically all the values will come. Now this graph is in the third quadrant, so your voltage and the current values will come negative. So this is how you do it very, very, effectively. So once you have done using NPN transistor, using PNP transistor is just a 5 or 10 minutes task. Okay, and similarly, you can increase the value. Now I'm not doing it. I'm doing it for one last value of 5 volt over here. Then click on simulate. You will get another curve. And yet another table, you can fill it with these values. Fine. So in this manner, we can plot the input output characteristics of common base configuration using, first we have used using NPN transistor, and now we showed how to do it using PNP transistor. Okay. So I guess that is all for this session. And next time we will see the simulation for the common collector configuration. So until then, have a good day and thank you.